Here's Abbie Benford, just the way her family wants to remember her.
She gave us so much joy.
A 15-year-old kid from Hopkinton making the varsity field hockey team, dancing to One Direction. And learning to drive in a parking lot.
She had the world in front of her.
But for Abbie, the world was also full of danger.
She was allergic to peanuts, tree nuts, dairy, soy, and egg.
Amy and Stephen Benford say Abbie knew she was at serious risk for anaphylaxis. That's when the body's immune system overreacts to a substance causing a massive allergic response. Patients can experience swelling, trouble breathing, sometimes vomiting. Even though symptoms can take up to 30 minutes to develop, they can spiral quickly out of control.
If you don't introduce epinephrine to inhibit the reaction, you'll lose the patient. The patient will die.
Just days before her 16th birthday, Abbie told her parents her stomach bothered her. Then they heard Abbie wheezing. Amy grabbed an EpiPen.
And her last words were, "Hurry, Daddy."
Stephen called 911.
In the 6 minutes it took for Hopkinton EMS to arrive at our house, Abbie went from sitting up like you are right now, telling me she couldn't move air, to on the floor.
At Children's Hospital in Boston, doctors kept Abbie on life support.
I think half the town of Hopkinton came through the hospital to say goodbye.
Abbie Benford died December 18th, 2013.
The sequence of events happened so fast that it just got out in front of us and we lost her.
Today, Abbie's story and her smile inspire this engineering team at Harvard's Wyss Institute in Boston.
It's going to be like the dark purple color.
They're developing new ways to detect anaphylaxis at its earliest stages, even before someone might feel symptoms. This tiny sensor can monitor blood and other fluids for increases in histamine levels.
That means that you're having an allergic reaction.
And this new device, actually nicknamed Abbie, delivers life-saving epinephrine without the swing and jab.
Take the cap off, put it against your arm, and press the button.
The technology is still in development, but the Benfords believe these devices will someday soon save lives.
They've always put the name Abbie on there, and it's very, very powerful for us.
She will save lives, and that's meaningful.
So the ultimate goal is combining both devices to make this wearable, and that way a patient could receive epinephrine automatically as soon as that sensor detects the first signs of anaphylaxis. But of course, the Keep Smiling for Abbie Foundation needs donations to make that happen. So if her story has touched you, if you want to learn more, please check out our WCVB app.